I got nothing. You might as well say face liver.
Liver or face? Liver and onions.
Okay.
When you're searching for a destination, explore a world of conversation.
Get lost in aimless flow. Ride with the Tangent Station Show.
The train departs. We're ready to rant. Time to get your ticket stamp.
Stay on topic.
Where's the fun in that?
You know better when we're off to chat.
You want me to vomit?
Snake bite.
Oh, you ever have that drink? Snake bite.
I'm afraid, you know.
Do you know what it is?
What?
It is two shots of Yukon Jack, and they take Rose's lime juice and go, whoop, tricked you. And real quick, just a touch of it. And this is something I discovered when I don't have a lot of money, but we wanted to go to the club. But in order to dance and get liquid courage, you had to be a little tipsy. I did.
But not me.
But the snake bite would do it. If you didn't have money, you had under $10, you had that snake bite, you were good for a couple of hours.
Or sex on the beach.
No, they had that. Where I went, they had the BBD, Burgundy's Big Drink.
Oh.
And it was just nothing but sugar and
spice.
Vodka. And that's nice. Probably why I can't drink vodka now. I had a little vodka jello shot a few years back when Jeff and I were playing in the club's music. And someone bought it for me. I was like, oh, cool. You know, I took it. And I was like, oh, what was in that? Instant headache. Oh, vodka jello shots. I'm like, no wonder. I can't. It just, I guess it goes straight to my head. All right. What do we got today?
You know, we look much fatter on TV.
I didn't want to bring that up.
We're not as fat as we seem to be.
And we're not on TV. We're on your devices. And
yes, whatever.
See, look here. I've got, that is R2-D2. Okay? Because this is an Android phone.
But look what I have.
Ba-dum-bum. Yeah, you got, what do you got? Nothing.
I got
plain Jane.
No, it has.
Oh, you put a sticker on it! Yay!
Jointly.
What's our letter of the episode?
W, as worker.
Why?
Why not?
Oh.
As Willis, worker.
W as in who?
What? Where and why?
Yeah.
Do you know?
You're behind on a few drinks. I can tell. The listener, because we just ripped off a bunch of them.
You know, have you ever noticed that about W? You go to where, you change W to a T, it's there. Where? There.
You sound like Joe Jackson. Where? There. Well, then there's your proof.
And then you have...
Is she really going out?
Then you have
with
what?
Him?
That.
Oh, my God.
Why?
You have this.
Why?
No. Stop the Sesame Street crap. It's bad enough I let you do letter of the episode.
Yeah. Far.
As... Oh, go ahead. 3, 2, 1.
I'm so glad he's my friend.
Otherwise, dem's fighting words.
Otherwise, he would not have any friends.
Well, the one I got's a big anal plug. Go.
Sweet. Oh, bunghole.
Bunghole. Is that your number one?
You know, no, the thing that I'm going to ask you questions here.
The thing that keeps you constipated.
You know, the bunghole, you know,
it kind of serves that
whiskey.
Purpose. Yeah, I know.
And actually, we went to a whiskey place. Amy got to pour her own bottle of whiskey, and they
from
said,
the bunghole.
Yeah, and they said, "Let me help you with your bunghole." And I forgot about it, and I was going to get mad at the guy, but then I remembered. So I have the five questions.
He did that on purpose, you know,
because
it's hilarious if you're 12.
It is, butthead.
My bunghole.
That was last episode. Okay.
Right. 3, 2, 1.
So,
but I'm wearing the same clothing. You're not.
Before we do 3, 2, 1, I'm gonna do five questions.
Fucking Celine Dion over here.
I'm gonna do five questions first.
Oh, hey, he's got five questions for me.
And he was surprised. He gave me the homework to do that, and I did it. So
I am surprised he did it.
So
you didn't do homework in school, did you, Johnny?
No. What is, okay, here you go. What is something you only do when you're bored? And why do you think of me?
let's see. Something I only do when I'm bored and I think of Willis? Yeah, I'm going to go with masturbate. No, I'm never that bored. Eat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you think of me when you eat?
Yeah, I think of how much you drive me insane and what podcast thing I got to figure out and do.
Okay.
Gotcha. That's self-care.
That was last episode.
It doesn't matter.
If you were famous, what would your stage name be, and why would it be Georgie Pines?
Georgie Pines? Georgie Porgie Puddin' Pines.
Well, if you could...
I'd kiss the girls and make them cry.
Yeah.
Why would it be Georgie Pines? Well, it wouldn't be. What would my stage name be? Sweet Pea Glenrose would be my stage name.
Sweet Pea Glenrose. Why?
Yeah. First cat, first street I lived on.
Okay.
Oh. I guess that's your porn name, but I could make it my drag name,
you
right?
You could.
Sweet Pea Glenrose. So, and there's your reason. There's your reason why. Right here, right now. Jesus, Jones, you got another question for me?
Yeah, well, this, I just realized I asked this question before I knew what the numbers
were. Well, there's only five.
Music.
Oh.
At the end, so, but.
Hole. Well, you're going to keep saying it. I'll keep saying it.
If you were coming out, on stage, what would your intro
Diana
song,
Ross, I'm coming out.
What would your stage name be? Or what would your song be?
If I'm coming out, what, as gay?
No. If you're coming out on stage.
Oh.
What would your... you got it. The introduction pause was for the joke.
Okay, all right. I understand.
See, I even copyrighted it.
Yeah, didn't work, did it?
No.
But you mean coming out, as I can see in all caps there, as a gay joke?
No, yes.
Yeah, yes. So I'm going to go with, please don't talk about love tonight. Your sweet talking won't make it right.
Yeah, I do.
I love the nightlife. I got to boogie.
Not Lauren Bridges.
You know, no, it's Alicia Bridges.
Alicia Bridges.
I swear that Billy Idol is her child.
I love
Billy. Watch the video with Alicia Bridges. Not with her, but of Alicia Bridges, and you'll see why I said that.
And if you could watch it with Alicia Bridges, that means you know her.
Yeah. You didn't know there was going to be homework, did you?
Nope. Okay.
Not you, them.
If you could pick between dating a supervillain or a super...
Yes. Go ahead. Wait. I got to use this for him.
If you could pick between dating a supervillain or a superhero, who would it be? And why Gargamel?
It wouldn't be Gargamel. God. And that's not a supervillain. It's a cartoon villain.
But it's still...
I'd smack his ass. Dating a supervillain. Or a superheroine, right? Hero. I guess I could choose male or female if I wanted, but...
Yeah, I mean, you know, it was the 2000s.
I'm going to go with the Linda Carter version of Wonder Woman. Just because...
Don't say a word. Okay,
If you give me a few seconds, I'll get there.
But Gal Gadot doesn't look too bad. Either, but not nobody will be Linda.
Yeah.
Linda!
She has a new song out, by the way.
Linda Carter does?
Yeah.
I didn't know she sang.
Yeah. She was pretty good, in fact. She was multi-talented, but I just saw...
Oh, I'm sure she is.
Swiping my phone, and yeah, hey.
Is that what we're calling it now, swiping the phone?
Multi-talented. Yeah, I call it.
I was swiping
Is that
my
code
phone
for something?
With my hand wife.
Yes. So I'm shopping for... amplifier, a speaker with Jeff, and I had one already. He needed one so we could have stereo, and we're at Sam Ash, which they're going under, but that sucks. And I walk away, look at some things, and come back because they're in the process of checking out. And if you've ever been to a music store, any of them, it takes forever to check out because those guys they've paperwork and they freak out. They don't know what they're doing. Sorry, but that's the truth. And
that's
so
why they're going
it's
out of business.
Well, maybe.
Could be.
Waiting in line for forever. But he's checking out, and I come back over and lean against the counter, and he sees me there, and Jeff goes, he knows my cousin Dick. So I don't react, and I lean over and go, is that code for something? Because I had no idea what he meant. He knows my cousin Dick. I'm like, is that code for something? So he's on the floor laughing. It is funny, but not for someone like you.
I don't know what Dick is.
That's true. Been a long time since he rock and rolled.
Been a long time.
Give me the next question.
Okay. I've been waiting. When I wrote this one last night, and I've been waiting to see this. What's your favorite dance move to turn people on?
How in the world would I know how to turn people on? I mean, look at this. My favorite dance move to turn people on. I'm going to go with the 40-year-old overbite. You know.
Yeah. All right, Billy.
You ever been to a wedding? What do you mean, Billy? Billy? Oh, Crystal.
Crystal.
Yeah, it's true. Ever no, since
I
he
been
said
to a wedding,
that.
I used to DJ weddings.
Right. So you know what I'm saying. And it's from ever since that was in When Harry Met Sally. You know, the 40-year-old overbite. I've noticed everyone does that. That's why the joke is so good and lasting. No, I don't have a move because they never play a Wild Wild West. I used to live downtown and I could do that slide back and
forth. Talking about Cool Moe Dee?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or the Wild
there was
Wild
a
West
dance
by,
to that. You know, slide and kick the groin out that way, slide this way, kick the groin up. Yeah.
And think that, of. Did that get you any men?
No. Quite the opposite. I used to be good looking, thin, and could dance.
You know what they say, you can dance if you want to, but you can leave your friends behind.
I did leave my friends behind. They never went. And the people that I went dancing with, I'm no longer friends with.
Yeah.
It just didn't last. Yeah, club people.
You know, that's how I mean I met. And
right.
I thought I was going to be a club person the rest of my life, but I didn't think I was going to be almost 55. However old I'm getting.
Yeah, that seemed old back then, didn't it?
Did. Oh, my God. It
and now we find the truth. It is old.
Oh, exactly.
All the ailments.
So let's do the top with 3, 2, 1.
Is that
one.
It? That's my 5?
Yeah.
That was it?
Yeah.
I was having fun.
I could have wrote 10.
No.
I had tons
we'll
of them
save
in my
them
head.
For another
I
episode.
Will. So we're doing the 3, 2, 1. The 3 tonight is 3 action figures.
Yes. Toys, action figures that you played with the most or just loved and remember and that you think of.
Yeah.
You want me to go first? No order. The Mego Batman, you know, where the arm would break because the rubber band would come loose in there, the old 70s toys.
Yeah, I love that.
And it had like the Adam West costume because that was what was popular. And so, yeah, that was in the...
They had Catwoman, too. You can undress her.
I love going to Kmart and just looking at all the action figures I never got.
Kmart is the old version of what Walmart is today. People used to walk around in their skivvies in Kmart.
Well, now they do it in Walmart.
And now the blue light special is downtown. It's the red light special.
This guy would know. I haven't used the Vine Street joke in a long time.
50 is same down.
50 to make you go away.
Okay. Mine in no order, all 4 Kiss dolls.
Oh.
I remember getting those in the orphanage.
You got all 4?
Yeah.
Wow. I only had 2 of them.
As an orphan. You should have been an orphan.
I had the important ones, though. Gene and Paul.
I had...
Probably couldn't find Peter and Ace, and why.
You can't find your Peter?
Same as you. We went over that in the...
Oh, we did, didn't we? But yes. So I really liked those. And when I was... I remember taking my Kiss dolls and having them beat up my sister's Barbie.
You're like... if you ever watched that show, it was on Friday evenings on ABC, and it was like Saturday Night Live, but it was on Friday evenings. And a lot of... Larry David was on it. Michael Richards was on it. So Michael Richards used to... put this army helmet on that didn't fit, and he acted like a kid in the skit. And they had this big stage, and he could go under, and it was his backyard. And his sister would come out and play on the steps with her dollies, and he'd hear her and go up, and he would always do things to her Barbie dolls. His G.I. Joe would blow him up, and that it was a great skit. So you saying that reminded me of it.
Yes, indeed, it's nice. We'll have our picnic here, okay? Okay, yeah, let's. Give me a kiss, baby. You know what I like. No! Kids, have a picnic. Okay, let's do that. Put the blanket right here. Isn't it beautiful here, Julia? So romantic. Come here, baby. Give me a kiss. Okay, I'll give you a kiss. I know what you like. I love you. I love you. Get some flowers from over in the garden and put them on there. And do this over here. Put the flowers. Get some more leaves out of the tree. That's what I will do.
You know what's weird?
No.
I'm only listening to half of you. I still only hear you. I can't hear your voice through my ear.
Okay.
I'm just saying. Okay. Okay, what's yours?
Oh, is it my turn?
Wait, did you already start?
You said
yeah,
the four
Superman. Kisses. Yes, 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 yes. Go ahead.
Batman.
Okay, that's one.
He's better. The Kenner Darth Vader with the red lightsaber and the vinyl, black vinyl cape that always got torn up.
I couldn't afford that. I was
couldn't afford it. My aunt worked at Kenner. I had Kenner toys I didn't even open. I didn't like the 12-inch figures. They didn't fit in my aunt.
So you had...
I knew you were going there.
You had Kenner or Barbie, right?
No, Kenner.
Ken or Bobby.
No. Stop it. That's not... That's bad.
I don't speak language.
Yeah. Which one?
I don't know.
Screw Healy.
Okay. You know what my...
Screwed ups.
You know what my favorite was? Because I was poor at one time. Not anymore, thank God.
Well, we're just talking about the ones that we had and enjoyed and loved. And you blew them all with having four Kiss dolls. You weren't that poor.
In orphanage. I got them in the orphanage. We get what... But these... Remember those little green guys? Think of Toy Story.
Yeah, the green army.
I love those.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't even think of that, or that would have been
cheaper by the dozen.
Used to get the ones,
by the way, cheaper by the dozen.
Yeah, that were like 6 inches tall.
Yeah,
they had a version of.
They had like one down, and they had shooting.
Oh yeah, those were great.
Yes, I didn't think about doing.
I love the weird plastic bag they came into.
Oh, yeah,
it was a weird. Yeah, it smelled good.
But remember,
So that was national because you were in Colorado during this, and I was out here.
No, I would actually, when I had those green men, it was in
California.
California.
Wow.
When I was poor.
So it is literally national.
Yeah.
Across the whole nation.
Yeah. Okay. Your last one.
No, you. Oh, you did green
men. Green men, remember?
By Ideal, the Evil Knievel.
Oh, I forgot that. And he had a bike.
Yeah.
And you could put him on.
And a ramp. The box became a ramp.
Yes.
You cut down the side and bent it and. It told you to do that on the box.
It's yeah. Great.
Evil Knievel.
Just don't do it at somebody's
Our
face.
Editor, Andy, would kill me if I didn't put that on there. As I thought of it, I was like, yeah, I definitely have to put that on there because we've both talked about, we've had long conversations about playing with Evil Knievel, the doll, not the man. God rest his soul.
Robbie.
Yeah, he died too recently.
Yeah, doing the same damn thing. Isn't it bad when a father and son die doing the same things they
love? What was that trapeze family was the same? It was almost
Flying
becoming...
Burrito Brothers? No.
I don't know. That was a band. The
Tedeschi's, no.
They got a famous name that we can't remember.
They're so famous.
Yeah.
So
well, you just don't hear about them anymore. They're long gone.
Time. Look it up, Jackie.
There's your homework. It's not a ball.
It's not. But hopefully you have it. Everybody.
Famous trapeze family.
Famous Willandes.
Willendas. The
Willendas brothers.
Was it Waltzing Willendas? Or?
Yeah, something like that. Am I right?
Yes, you are. It's Willenda. And didn't they...
Yes. Never mind, Jackie.
There was also a famous family that they did the big pole and walked between the Twin Towers, I thought, or they did tightrope walking.
I did my big pole walking, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, W, that was a great segue into the W's.
Yes.
Just saying. My number one is doing a number two. Superman.
Oh, yeah.
So I had them actually, him fighting.
Amigo?
Yeah.
With the rubber band arms?
No, this was the, like...
Sturdy.
Yeah.
Okay.
The one that he would fight with Kiss, and he'd attack Barbie and stuff. He was a badass movie.
So you had Bizarro,
I made him that way, yeah.
Remember Justice League cartoons?
Yeah, yeah.
Bizarro was the
Superman. But yeah, Superman.
All right. The next topic, the two. We're doing 3, 2, 1 here. Top two karaoke songs, the songs you performed at Bring the House Down, or something along those lines.
What? I'm going to start off with, before I give you my top two, ICCC, is whenever I went to a place called, I don't remember the name of the, but I'd get up there and I'd sing Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer. I'd get up there, the whole place goes and watches me and gets up by the stage and claps, and that's a good old time.
Maybe, it was fun.
Maybe I should do it with clothes on next time, I don't know.
Yeah.
So, but really, my first one is what they're going to, I sing this and I'm good at this. I sing this like he does and I make it punk. Like, and it's my
like
way.
Like he does.
And now the end is near. And so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few.
Like My Way by Frank Sinatra.
You sing it like he does and you make it punk.
Yeah, because I'll switch, because I, you know, I'm, you know, I just do.
Okay.
But My Way, Frank, they're also going to play that at my funeral, so.
Yes. I'll make sure of it.
Yeah.
Brandy, Looking Glass.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's a great new group that's probably sold more hit records in the last year than we have. And also,
You could say that about just about any group.
Well, here's one of the many groups that have sold a lot more records than we have. Ladies and gentlemen, Looking Glass.
Ships a day, load of sailors pass the time away, talk about their homes. There's a girl in this harbor town, she works day and whiskey down. The soup brand day, fetch another round, she serves them whiskey and wine. The sailors say brand day,
really?
There's a port on a western bay. I've done it when we went downtown to Tokyo Kitty or whatever that was called.
I thought you were going to do who does Heather hate?
Oh, Barbara Streisand. That was just at home. I wouldn't do that out in public.
We
that
need
was
to
too
do
much
that.
Fun.
May 4th.
No.
Be with you.
All right.
Okay.
Man, I hate that. May the 4th be with you. And don't forget the Return of the Sith on the 5th. Return of the 5th.
I never heard that.
Oh, God.
I don't care.
All right, so your second one. We got a jam here.
Friends in Low Places.
That was for me.
Blaming all my runes. I showed up in bells and ruined your black tie fear. Last one to know. The last one to show, I was the last one you thought you'd see there. And I saw the surprise and the fear in his eyes when I took his glass of champagne. And I toasted you, said, honey, we made me through. But you'll never hear me complain. Cause I got friends in low places where the
I'm very, very, I mean, those are, I mean, that's the ones I sing by myself, but my wife and I have some, but
yeah,
I could sing that, and people love when I sing that, because yeah, I know all the verses.
If ever, when I was playing out, when I used to play in places, if you're not, if the crowd just is not it's a crowd pleaser. So you just pull that one out, and you pull out Brown Eyed Girl and Jimmy Buffett.
Or Caroline.
If they're not in. Yes, that one too.
Yep. Exactly.
So my other one is How Long Has This Been Going On?
Really?
By Ace, yeah. I just do things that I can do well. I don't want to...
Yeah.
And that's what people appreciate more, at least the karaoke places I've been to. Lately, we go to some karaoke places, and there's ringers in there, lots of them, lots of people that can really sing.
But we haven't
that
been in
should
a long
be in
time.
A band. Yeah.
You know, we do it now at Sharice's house, and that's when I try out new stuff. Like
that's the place to do it.
That's Amore, you know, by, you know. So, yeah. All right, number one, your intro music. Go ahead and start.
If you had intro music, like a baseball batter's yeah. walk up, what song would it be and why? Mine is... Return of the Mac.
Yes, I cry. Yes, I cry.
You lied to me. Mark Morrison, Return
yeah,
of the Mac.
I know, I'm like,
look
what?
Out, that's a great, yeah. I'm Return of the Mac, you know, with the baseball, I'm your Mac Daddy. You're not buying it, are you?
Not a clue.
Okay, you don't know the song.
I do know the song, okay. But.
It was either that or Here Come the Hot Stepper. I thought, the lyrical gangster.
I went with Return
of the Mac. It's
I think
lesser
you should
known.
Come out with Cotton Eye Joe.
No, hate that. Is that yours?
No, mine is Wrong, Depeche Mode.
God, Depeche Mode.
Because I'm always in the wrong place at the wrong time.
You're always picking the wrong song, and it starts with Depeche Mode. Yours should be...
Have
you met me?
Yeah, exactly.
Your song should be...
Oh, you're going to... Okay.
They're going to put me in the movies, and all I got to do is act naturally. That should be your song.
Why?
Because...
Why not?
Have we derailed them enough? What? I feel I have.
I.
What's that?
It's my gun.
Oh.
This has been a Touch of Madness production. Brought to you by the creative minds at Tommy Twins Media.
Thank you for traveling with us today as we navigate thoughts along the way.
Always something fresh, that will be clear. It's time to say goodbye, but have no fear.
Take another ride without a map. There's no guarantee
it won't be crap.
Let's meet up again without hesitation. Join us again on
Tangent Station.